Hello everybody, my name is Konstantinos Kyritopoulos, and in this video we are talking about the research method and what we need to put into the relevant chapter of a thesis. So, research method. The first thing that one should consider is practically the research approach or philosophy. So, the first subsection would be research approach. Research approach is practically giving, showing the stance that we are going to hold against research. And we are going to talk in a dedicated to research approach video about all these things. The next thing that you need to do is to justify the research methods. So, when we are talking about justification of research methods, is really why we are using the specific methods. First of all, which methods are we using? So, are we doing interviews? Are we doing questionnaires? Are we doing focus group? And of course, why we pick these methods? Sometimes it's very easy. Most of the times to pick a method, but most of the times we need to really think carefully whether the methods that we will be using are really capable of addressing the objectives. It is very helpful if we go back in the literature and see what others that research on similar projects have done. If we justify the research method, then we can go to what we will call research plan. So, the research plan is really how are we going to execute the research, specifically when it comes to the order. For instance, are we doing first the interviews and then the questionnaires? We might have a problem where we want to gain an initial understanding through interviews and then be able to construct questionnaires and use them after the interviews. Or, on the other hand, we might be doing questionnaires initially to gain an understanding of how the professionals, the respondents are seeing our problem, how do they see it, and then conduct a focus group in order to find out whether our initial findings from the questionnaire seem interesting, seem valid, or they have any problems with the eyes of the experienced respondents during the focus group. In research plan, sometimes we also have the opportunity to connect research objectives with the research methods. And this is very important. So, in one of the chapters, of the initial chapters, say introduction or background of research, chances are that you had a subsection which was research aims and objectives. It would be very good for each research objective that you have identified in this subsection to assign a specific research method on how you are going to address it. And this is to make sure that there are no research objectives which are not really research on the execution while you are executing the research. So try to make a kind of connection. So if these are your research objectives and these are your research methods, make sure that there is, so these are objectives and these are methods. Make sure that all the objectives are handled by at least one research method. One method might address or worked in order to address more than one objective. The last part of the research method subsection would have to do with ethics considerations. And this is very important. So when you are designing your research, you need to make sure that you have considered all the ethical part. So make sure that you are not harming respondents, that you are not exposing researchers to problems, and of course, make sure that you communicate the research correctly to the potential respondents, which means having an information sheet, having a consent form, and having a proper introductory of research letter when you are at the recruiting process. Good luck.